Hey all, this is Ray with Unicorn Riot. We're here in Las Vegas, Nevada for the DEFCON 27 Hacking Conference. We're about to speak with a security professional and professor named Rick Hansen, who worked with a group of college students from Hawk Security to test the LIDAR systems in autonomous driving vehicles. I saw you talk in the car hacking village. What was going on in there?
It was really interesting. We got an idea just when we saw someone gave us an opportunity to test a piece of LIDAR, which is you use light much like the human eye, except it measures distance. Instead of painting a picture, it measures distances to things.
You were experimenting with how you can influence LIDAR, maybe to give misreadings. What made you start this project? What kind of got you interested in that?
There'll be AI and machine learning in cars, which will make the decisions for you. They'll decide there's something up ahead. We're going to turn left, we're going to turn right. And I'm wondering, What if we could fool it? How could we fool it? And we looked at a very basic level. What would someone who only had access to a grocery store and a hardware store be able to do? Because people are putting lots of money in the other things. We tried to see if we could sow chaos for a few dollars. We had some things that didn't work. For example, if you think of it, a wall is a bunch of points. And we wondered if we could create a virtual wall using a kind of powder. We had experiments that failed. We threw confetti in the air, but it didn't last long enough. And we found a mixture of powders that we could get to be suspended for, now we're up to 32 seconds, enough to create enough of an obstacle where a car would come to a halt.
Wow. That sounds pretty dangerous.
There's something called chaff, which almost everyone has heard of, and it looks like a cloud on a screen. You throw small pieces of wire the proper length for the radio signal, and it's very efficient at reflecting it back. It's like holding a mirror. So if we can create a dust that puts this out together, then you would fool both sensors.
LIDAR works then by sending out that signal and then it bounces back. So that's how when you bounces it, off.
It's spinning and you'll see something that looks like a little police light on top. Okay. And inside that it's got several little diodes that are emitting light and they spin many times per second and they're painting circles, send a pulse, move a little bit, send a pulse, move. So if you think of it, it's like you're drawing lines. And with the images we're providing, you'll see these lines are 6 inches to a foot apart, and it uses that to try and decide what sort of objects are in its way and how fast they're moving.
So you found that you could create a wall with flour, and what else were we finding?
CD, the surface of a CD or DVD, they use the same frequency light, and they trap it in little wells. So if you were to cover a car with DVDs, it would have a very low signature on object. Mm-hmm. It would look great to the human eye. You'd like, oh, that's really obvious, but the car would go, yep, nothing there.
Interesting.
Yeah.
So you've not only found how to trick it into kind of seeing objects that aren't there, but also not seeing objects that are there.
That is correct.
Did you have any unexpected results in your study?
Yes, flat black paint, which should a type which they use on charcoal grills, which should absorb heat, massive fail.
How does a trash bag act like an F-117 fighter jet?
If you get the right trash bag with the right coating, and we didn't have enough money to go ahead, and I'm certain it's $1,000 an ounce or something for the coatings, and there are coatings you can get which do reduce LIDAR, but they're used for making your headlights less visible to police LIDAR. To imitate an F-117, you look at the angles on it, you get different types of black material, and you try and, there's an angle somewhere in here that's too high and it reflects light back to you, too shallow, and the rough edges, even though they're microscopic, reflect light back to you. So there's an angle somewhere in here, usually, that will reflect. If you put a piece of cardboard in there or have someone in there, like myself, I sat in the trash bag because there's too much paperwork and the student gets run over. You pull it at a tight angle, light hits it, light bounces off. And that light, which doesn't bounce off, a lot of it gets absorbed. So there's always a little bit of light that comes back, but you can't see it until you get very, very close. This is interesting research. Just anyone who wanted to undertake it, understand that you've got to be careful because it sounds like a lot of fun, but you've got to take care or bad things can happen.
Yeah.
Be a little bit careful, and no matter who you are, you can buy a Raspberry Pi and do really cool stuff that can help us all. Just make sure you don't get anyone run over or get anything blown up in the process.